Debate in the Upper House on Thursday centered around the financing of the St. Jude Reconstruction Project. Earlier in August, the St. Lucia government and the Saudi Fund for Development signed an agreement for $200 million EC dollars towards the completion of the St. Jude Rehabilitation Project, which would also go toward the rehabilitation of the George Odlum Stadium. The EC $200 million is a loan with a five-year grace period at 2% interest. Government Senator Lisa Jawahir is lauding the government's efforts in securing the financing necessary for the completion of the project.
We have gone to Parliament on Tuesday. The Senate hopefully gets the permission of Parliament so we can pass the legislation that the government of St. Lucia can borrow the funds from the Saudi fund, which I believe is a very good negotiation for the people of St. Lucia. The 2% interest, also the deferment in payments should we encounter some natural disaster. We know St. Lucia is highly prone to climate change.
Opposition Senator Angelina Ferropolius indicated that the opposition United Workers Party is not averse to borrowing for the completion of the St. Jude Hospital, but questions the practicality of the St. Lucia Labour Party administration in returning to the old St. Jude site, as opposed to completing the structure commenced under the United Workers Party administration.
What we're saying is the $200 million that is being borrowed, why can't $50 million out of that, because that's what's needed to complete the state-of-the-art facility that the UWP administration started, use this and deliver a state-of-the-art facility with lots of services that St. Lucians can access rather than going overseas, rather than going spending thousands of dollars to go overseas to access healthcare.
Leader of opposition business Dominic Fede also questioned the current administration's rationale for returning to the old structure.
You are 90% complete and you need $200 million? I mean, why are you not leveling with the people of St. Lucia? They are misleading everyone and they are trying to distract from the main purpose and the main argument. The argument is that they are continuing to put $200 million of taxpayers' money into a mess. John Peters, an engineer, said that this is the worst piece of public management that he had seen in the history of St. Lucia.
Leader of Government Business in the Upper House, Senator Gibeon Ferdinand, says questions surrounding the St. Jude Reconstruction Project have been adequately addressed, and what is left now is to deliver on the promise of completing the St. Jude Hospital.
If you had followed the discussion in the debate of the Lower House on Tuesday, all of these questions would have been answered about drawings and DCA approval. That argument, that back and forth, I don't want to get involved in that. I think these questions have been ventilated. As I said, what is important is not who did drawings and who didn't have approval. Right now, I think all of that has been answered. And my interest is to see to it that this motion today is approved so that the monies that we have sourced can be put into use to complete the facility for people of this country.
Opposition Senator Nancy Charles, however, maintains that pertinent questions remain unanswered about the cost to complete the facility.
What we are very confused about, and I think everybody keeps asking, is how much money is required to complete St. Jude's, whichever phase you discuss or agree on. Where is the report? Because I listened on Tuesday to every single parliamentarian who spoke, especially the Prime Minister. No document has been presented to the public of St. Lucia to say that it's going to cost us $10 million, $20 million, $100 million to complete. No date has been given for construction, and no report has been given in terms of it's going to take us 10 months, a year, 2 years to complete the refurbishment or the construction of St. Jude.
Prime Minister Philip Jepia has expressed optimism that the project will be completed before the end of the Labour Party's term in office. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.